Hey y'all, welcome to What Chelsea Eats. Thank you so much for joining me today. I am going to show you how to make this vegetable wrap that I've been making for the last week, and people have been saying, how do you make it? It is so good, so filling, and it is a replacement for like just having a salad. And I am also going to show you one of my favorite sauces that I made and made up last week to go with this wrap. So if you'd like to see how I make it, please stay tuned. First, we're going to start off with the sauce. This is very, very easy to make. There's not a lot of ingredients to it, and it actually makes about 16 ounces of dressing or dip. And so you can have it for a few days, depending on how much you like it. I mean, you actually could eat the whole thing in one day if you wanted to. There would be nothing wrong with that. But usually my husband and I both eat on this dressing for 2 days. Remember, I'm going to put all of the ingredients and the measurements in the description box below. So I'm using my Vitamix blender, and I've put the white beans or great northern beans or cannelloni beans, whatever you want to call them, into the blender. And I also added 1/4 cup of hemp seeds and 2 cloves of garlic. You can put more if you like things more garlicky. And I even add some regular powdered garlic because I like it a little smoky. And then that salt and pepper to taste, and then I'm adding some dill. If you don't like dill, you can add whatever else you want. I'm adding chipotle because I like the flavor of chipotle, but you could use red pepper flakes. I absolutely love the flavor combinations in this particular dressing. Now, I'm using about 3/4 cup of water because that's the consistency that I like. You might want to start off with 1/2 cup of water because maybe you don't want it as thin as I like mine. And you can also add more water if you like it thinner. So I'm going to squeeze the juice of 1 lemon in this. And it's possible that a lime would work in this dressing as well, but I'm really not sure because I haven't tried it with a lime. I just know that this flavor combination is absolutely insanely delicious. I eat it on my salads. I eat it as a dip for this wrap. And I am sure I can put it on all kinds of other things like steamed vegetables and things of that nature. So just keep that in mind when you make this dressing. Then all you're going to do is blend the ingredients until they are completely smooth. And really, that's it. It took maybe about 30, 40 seconds in this blender. If you don't have a high speed blender, it may take longer. I doubt it. There's no tough ingredients in this recipe. And then once you're done blending it, all you do is store it in a mason jar. I have a 16 ounce wide mouth mason jar that I use for storing just about everything. But this is a perfect place to store this dressing. And it will keep in the refrigerator for about 5 to 6 days. I wouldn't keep it any longer than that, but make sure you put a lid on it if you want to keep it. So now let's get into making the wraps. I am going to use Swiss chard because I think Swiss chard has the biggest leaves, and that's what we're wanting, is to spread the leaves out as far as we can so you can roll the wrap and you can fit as many ingredients in it as you can. But the thing you're going to need to do is cut out the stem, and you can save the stems and put them in your smoothies because they are full of nutrients. But you want to basically get rid of that tough part, and it's not really that tough, but it's just tough to wrap it with that stem sticking out. So I have 3 leaves that I'm using for this particular wrap. Now, you don't have to use Swiss chard. If you don't like Swiss chard, you can use kale. You can use regular butter lettuce. You can use green leaf lettuce. You can use romaine. Whatever type of lettuce you absolutely want, you can use. But do you see how I made like a surface for all of these ingredients that I have to sit on? And I'm gonna put it in the middle, just like if I was getting a burrito at some place like Moe's or Chipotle. So you'll see how I layered the ingredients in just a second. So first, the other thing is you can put any type of ingredients in this wrap that you want. Don't go out and buy special ingredients. I am just using what I have in my refrigerator for salads. So I cut up enough ingredients for two, and the recipe down in the description box is going to be for two wraps. So the measurements that you see, that's what it's going to be based on. So first I had red peppers. Now I am adding some cucumbers. I've got some red onions. If you don't like red onions, don't put red onions in it. If you like white onions, put white onions in it. If you don't have cucumbers, use zucchini. If you don't have red peppers, use, you know, green peppers, whatever it is that you want. So I had some leftover quinoa. I normally don't even put quinoa in the wrap, but I had some leftover, so I'm gonna add that to the wrap. Next, I'm gonna add some shredded cabbage for some crunch. You don't have to use red cabbage. You can use white cabbage. You can use Savoy cabbage. You can use whatever kind of cabbage you have on hand. The next ingredient I have is some sauerkraut. I love to put sauerkraut in my salads because it helps as a probiotic for that good gut health. I don't take probiotics, so to speak. I try to get it in my food. And so I have a half of an avocado, and I'm going to use a quarter of the avocado for each wrap. When you're detoxing, you want to keep your fat very, very low. So that's why you see I don't put a lot of fat in the wrap. So what do I have next? Okay, so I have some broccoli slaw. And just sprinkling that in. I mean, whatever you have in your refrigerator, just use it. And then I have some sprouts, and I love sprouts. Baby sprouts are so full of nutrients, y'all. The thing is when you have reproductive issues, especially if you have your hair loss, or you've had heavy bleeding, or just deficiencies in general, or you're feeling fatigued or tired, sprouts are a good thing to add. So then I added some carrots. So now it's time to roll this puppy. So all I'm doing is rolling just like as if I had a tortilla. You fold it in, and then you fold the sides in, and you keep on folding the sides in, and then you roll it a little bit more, fold the sides in, and then you roll it and roll it. And there you have it. You've got your wrap. And the thing that I do is once the thing is wrapped, I wrap it in some either wax paper, whatever I have on hand, or some parchment paper. So in this case, I've got some wax paper. Some people say don't use wax paper, but I don't get bent out of shape about it. It's only there so that I can wrap the wrap up, and then so that I can properly cut it in half and then put it on a plate or store it or whatever it is I want to do with it. So you see here, this one is going to be for my husband. And you see, I'm just going to cut it in half and slice it down. I kind of do it at an angle. So look at it. Isn't it beautiful? And you get all those flavors all wrapped together. And when you use the dip, oh my goodness, it's just a beautiful experience with these salad wraps. And you can make them different all the time because you just put whatever type of ingredients you enjoy. So what do you think? Do you think you'll make this as a change of pace from a salad? Something you could pack to take to work with you? And then look at that dip. So delicious. But if you like this video, please give it a thumbs up, share it with a friend. Don't forget to subscribe. And until next time, y'all, take care. Much love.